entire family is dismissed from this unit gathering in the big tent to the various classes that are held in other parts of the ground. Children in under kindergarten in one place, one through the sixth grade in other places. Dr. Paul Jackson, the Bible teacher, is president of the Baptist Bible Seminary in Johnson City, New York. His words of wisdom delivered daily at morning adult classes were an inspiration to all. Here the first through the sixth graders are listening to Bible stories and this particular one on the story of the crucifixion. And then it's song time, and the children select their favorite songs, and everybody sings. By the time camp is over, most of the 40 children will know all the songs by heart and be able to repeat the Bible stories. On benches under a shade tree, this group of preschoolers hear the story of Jesus and the little children, and to learn to join in with hand motions of their own. A few family pets roam the grounds too, which goes to show that the entire family is here on vacation. After 5 hours of study are spent in classes, the entire afternoon is devoted to recreation. Everyone joins in the softball game, whether they cheer or play. Archery, basketball, horseshoe, ping pong, you can play almost any game or participate in any sport you choose in this well-equipped camp. And all the equipment gets a good workout during the season. Perhaps the favorite sport of the 1,400 campers who participated in the regular Baptist camp this summer is the swimming time. The camp has 2,998 feet of lakefront with docks well-marked, swimming areas, a sandy beach, and a fully equipped and trained lifeguard. This land was purchased in 1950 with a desire to develop it into an adequate grounds for all our need. There are extensive plans for the future of the camp, and already some of the dreams are coming true. A large recreation field with baseball diamonds, tennis courts, and every conceivable facility is now being developed and is located on the north side of the camp. Work has already begun. And nearby, the Jensen Memorial Dining Hall is going up rapidly. When finished, the hall will seat 1,004 people and furnish facilities for many other activities as well. This is a view of the completed building, which is one of the largest dining halls in the state of Iowa. It will also serve as tabernacle space when the building is completed and ready for use. Such a program as this can only be maintained with the cooperation and help of others besides those who are actually there to develop the program. We operate with a board of 7 trustees, all of whom must be pastors here in the state of Iowa, and 7 businessmen, all of whom must be businessmen here in our state. We have felt that this balance between businessmen and pastors is the soundest way of administrating a camp of this size. Mr. Dale Murphy from Waterloo, Iowa, has been our chairman of our advisory board for several years. The young people have come to know and love him very much. He runs our concession stand, and this year fried about 2,000 hamburgers for the young people to eat and enjoy. We'd like to have Mr. Murphy say just a few words about what the camp means to the churches and what the churches means to the camp.
Thank you, Reverend Bob. Makes me feel right at home tonight to sit in front of this picture of Clear Lake. In fact, this is the closest I've ever set to water on dry land. But now upon the camp itself, the camp depends upon the churches of Iowa, Nebraska for a number of things. First of all, for its prayer support. The acquisition of the 52 acres on the north shore of Clear Lake is a direct result of prayer. Time does not permit the relating of the full story of the incidents leading up to the purchase of the grounds by the regular Baptist churches of Iowa and Nebraska. Also, the camp depends upon the churches for its financial support. In the first year of our present camp operation, the churches, 47 in number, gave over $53,000 towards the purchase of the grounds and to the fixed expenses incurred by the camp. From the churches each year must come the money for the annual fixed expenses of the camp. We are now well towards our goal of raising $150,000 through the selling of bonds, part of which is to pay for the Jensen Memorial Dining Hall. Then again, our camp depends on our churches for its attendance, for out of the churches must come our young people. This year we had a fine group of 535 juniors. We also had over 300 seniors. The camp originally was planned for the year. There has been added a camp where the entire family can come and enjoy the camp facilities. This year, over 200 families were in attendance to this camp. So our camp depends entirely upon the churches for its support in prayer, finances, and attendance.
Thank you, Murph. The people may be interested to know that this year we registered a total of 1,395 young people and adults, and to this group were fed 2,300 meals. 150 pounds of roast was necessary for taking care of one meal. From our camp, missionaries have gone to all sections of the world. We have pastors in many states, and young people's workers in many sections of the country received their first blessing at our camp. Our future plans are to be able to take care of at least 1,000 people every week. We hope you folks will come and see us. Send your children to camp and come yourself to Family Week next year. You'll enjoy the fun, the recreation, and the spiritual instruction.
Tonight, WOI-TV has visited the Family Week Camp sponsored by the Iowa-Nebraska Association of Regular Baptist Churches on Clear Lake, Iowa. We invite you to join us again next week on Churches of Iowa. Churches of Iowa was produced by Bob Phillips. Cinematography by John Raddatz. Technical director is Don Haar.